do the same melody. Let's make this G1. So, this is how we're going to change the emotion in the key of G1. So the notes in the key of G1 are in a totally different position than G6. G6 is the key, is the sixth note in the key of A sharp. And for the key of A sharp, we have the slop finger positions. That's how they start out. In the key of G, we have the same finger positions, but they're starting on the G note. Slop, slop. So we're going to change this to G1. Okay, here's G6 again, sixth note in the key of A sharp. There's the melody. Okay, now let's change it to G1, the key of G.
Play those two notes.
right here are notes in the key of G, and they're also notes in the key of F. Same exact notes, but the key of G has two different notes that are different from the key of F, and vice versa. The key of F has two different notes that are different than the key of G. And so if we play those two different notes, that'll help us to get that difference and feel that emotion. Melody, this is a melody. Key of G, G1, this is a G1. Key of G1. This is G1. The different notes. More of a twisty turnpike type feeling. I can feel it in my body. It's like twisting me inside. And then when we go to the key of F with the same melody, okay, we'll hit those two notes that are distinguished in the key of F. G2 melody. Better on the body. It doesn't twist the body so much. The key of G, it was like the key of, you know, playing G1 and distinguishing F from the key of G from the key of F. It was like taking my body like it was a wet sponge and twisting the water out of it. Ooh, I could just feel my body being wrenched. It's like I had extra moisture in me, and when I played those two notes, it wrung the extra moisture out of me. That's the key of F. Now let's change the note. Okay, we have G. Now let's go G5. Let's call it G5. Okay, so G is the fifth note in what key? The key of C. 5, 6, 7, 1. There's the C note. 1, 2, 1, 7, 6, 5. I know that finger position. I have it memorized, so I can find the key right off the bat just by going through my finger positions and my numbers. I know if this is a 5, I know it's a 5 slot pattern. It's a 5 slot finger position. I know the finger position is going to be like this. Skip a fret, finger. Skip a fret, finger. And I call it slop because it's like putting our fingers in between the two fingers here. And it's like sloppy ears. They're sloppy. They have play in them. So I call it slop. And I made it so that it rhymed with bop and hop. Because I came up with the bop name first. Then I thought of bop. And I came up with hop. I came up with hop to rhyme with bop, and then when I came back and made my name my finger positions for this particular stretch right here, I said, well, bop, hop, what's something that can rhyme with bop that can help me remember and give me a picture and I can explain? And so I came up with slop. So this is 5 slop. So this is 5, 6, 7. And I know after the 5 slop comes the 1 slop, after the 1 slop comes the 4 slop. Then after the 2 slops, we have the bops. 7 bop, 3 bop, and after the 2 bops, we have the 2 hops. 6 hop and 2 hop. So anyway, that's how I find my way around the fingerboard when I'm looking for my keys. If I say I'm going to turn this into G5, I say, okay, G is the fifth note, what key? 5, 6, 7, 1. Okay, there it is, the key of C. Alright, so now I do my melody, do the same melody. This is G5. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da I did G6 different. What was I doing? I was doing G6 and G2. Well, anyway, I made a mistake, but we get the idea. So anyway, so okay, so G1 sounds like G5. It's the same notes. So now we have to distinguish G1 from G5. Okay? And this is how we do it. This is G1, like I said. Has that wrenching feeling. Like twisted, like my body's like, feels like it's being twisted like a sponge. I can feel it right down the back of my spine. Like, so that's the key of G. Now I'll do the same melody for the key of C. It'll be G5. That are distinguished from the key of C, that are different from the key of G. Actually, it's really only one note different, so all I have to do is just go to that one note. That's the key of C. Key of C, this is the distinguishing note. Now, let's do the key of G. This is G1. Same melody, but I'll play the distinguishing note to distinguish the key of G from the key of C. And here we go. It still has that twist. But if I play that other note, gives it more of a twist. So there it is, that's the key of G. That's G1. Here's C. This is G5 in the key of C. More relaxed. Always coming back to that G5 target.